As a starting point of the maritime Silk Road in the Middle Ages, Quanzhou, the largest city of the Fujian province, was once a place where you could find people from the world's many different religions. So it's no surprise that Quanzhou has so many different kinds of temples. But among them, one temple amazes people more than others when they first come to Quanzhou. It's called the Bai Go Temple. Located on Quanzhou's Chengbei Road at the junction of Shanho Street and Mofan Lane, the Bai Go Temple is famous for the statue of a white dog, originally called Pi She Ye. At the same time, Su Shi Yina, a Fujian native who owns an antique shop in Quanzhou, also happens to be a descendant of the family that once owned the temple. She says the white dog in the temple has been misrepresented.
之前不是拜那个狗，后来就不知道，就说到可能清代的时候，因为我们把那个私家庙就捐出去给当地的铺问的人，就说让他们去有一个地方拜神的。但是我们家以前拜的那个也在那边，以前他就是拜一只狮子，哎，南卡他对狮子很崇拜的。 所以说它是带了一个狮子来拜，但是南卡的狮子跟中国的狮子不一样，南卡的狮子它是头发是很长的，就像你人的那个长头发一样，还有一个腰是很漂亮的一个狮子，那中国的狮子是剪头发，然后很雄壮的，所以他们就把那个狮子看成狗了。An
island country in the Indian Ocean, it's believed the ancestors of Sri Lankan people were lions, often leading it to be referred to as the Lion Country. And it's here where Su Shi Yina's ancestry originates from, and it's something that only became public knowledge when a new story broke in Quanzhou over two decades ago.
就有一天我看报纸，有一个博物馆海交馆的那个专家，他到山上去找，找到了那个释迦坑，然后后来就把我们家那个。 释迦坑的那一些古墓群，把那些墓碑都拿走了，拿到海交馆去展览了。所以说，看完就觉得很惊讶。Shi
Jia Kung is the burial site for the Shi family of Ceylon, as Sri Lanka was known in ancient times. Records from the Ming Dynasty indicate that Ceylon sent a prince back to China with the fleet of the Chinese explorer Zheng He to have an audience with the Ming Emperor. But on his way back from Quanzhou, just as the prince was about to board the ship, he was informed of a coup in his country. His cousin had not only killed his brothers, but also wanted to kill him as soon as he returned. Devastated, the prince stayed back in Quanzhou and assumed Shi as his Chinese last name, the identity he lived under for the rest of his days. And Su Shi Yina is one of the resulting descendants. Since the discovery of Shi Jia Kung, Su Shi Yina has been gradually going public with her identity as a descendant of the Shi family from Ceylon. And since then, she's been nicknamed by many as the Ceylon Princess. Initially, though, making her family history public wasn't her intention. What she wanted to do was protect her ancestors' gravestones the best she could.
当时我也不想让媒体知道，后来他们跟我解释说，就是说既然就是已经拿走了，而且报纸已经报道了，然后我现在就是重新把它放回去，怕以后遇到那个什么盗被人家盗走了，我听完以后觉得也有几分道理，后来就是算了，这件事情既然已经这样了，然后就以后有机会你帮我们那个。
With an agreement reached between the government and Su Shi Yina, the matter looked to have reached a conclusion. Su Shi's wishes of the gravestones being renovated and her link to the Shi family kept secret, both honoured. But that wasn't to be for long. The turbulence of land developments in the area of the burial site in 1998 put her back in the public eye.
98年的时候，他就把他承包给一个种那个什么果树的果农，那个果农他就 他就用推土机啊，然后旁边的那些放火烧那些树木，然后推土机要推给他平，他们要种果树嘛。那边印人家动工了怎么办？所以我又在想想办法了，想办法看到那报纸。 看到旁边一份报纸，有个热线电话，我就想，哦，这样不然就要让媒体知道了，不然怎么办？我就拿那个报纸，把那个电话热线电话打过去。他那个记者就反应很快，他就问我说：“你，那你跟我说你跟他是什么关系，跟那个古墓奇世家坑是什么关系？”他说：“我的把这关系说出来，我本来我不想说的，后来我就说：“哎，我跟他。”
我是他们的后代，我是那释迦坑的后代。Since then, Xu Xuyina's identity as the Ceylon Princess has spread all over Quanzhou and even reached her ancestral home in Sri Lanka.
然后我们就到斯里兰卡去，就是本来是想就去扫一下，结果就是没有想到规格就是非常高，就是他就那个行程他们全部安排好了，然后就是到了兰卡，就是一下飞机他们就已经那个什么，就几个部长啊，什么一些夫人啊，一些小孩在那边在欢迎呢。
Back in her ancestors' homeland and welcomed with a big reception. But for Xu Xuyina, the emotions were mixed.
我当时我就默默地跟那个，我就说，我说那个祖先，我说你们好，就是好几代人没完成的心愿，反正出门一定很想回家的，没有一个人什么出门不想回家的，落叶归根嘛。所以我说我带上你们，然后我们就是踏上了故土哈，就心里就觉得很酸，就是说就想到他们太那个了，就是没能回家，所以我觉得我就是带上他们的那个愿望，带上使命回去了。
As a descendant of a Sri Lankan prince, Xu Xuyina was even invited to reside in Sri Lanka. But having grown up in China, and Quanzhou in particular, home for her was irreplaceable. Xu Xuyina declined the Sri Lankan government's invitation, but has since become a key of cultural exchange between China and Sri Lanka. Many people from Sri Lanka visit her in China purely out of admiration.
就前几年也有一个跟我很有联系的，他就说一个叫他跟我说他叫甘米，然后他是兰卡科伦坡那边一个大一所大学的一个老师，跟我讲一些兰卡的事情。他跟我说，你在那个就我零二年我在那个植物园种了一棵树，纪念树。然后他说他们的同事啊、学生啊，还有一些市民啊，都很喜欢到那个树那棵树底下去照相，因为树底下有一个牌子嘛，所以他们都很喜欢到我种的那棵树底下去照相。Despite
the celebrity, Xu Xuyina still runs her antique shop as an ordinary girl of Fujian. As far as her other unique identity goes, her only hope is for her family gravestones and old houses to be better cared for and remain protected.
我就是旁边土门街这边这个老房子，斯里兰卡的官方跟民间的经常来，就到那个老房子里面去看一下。结果那个地方真的。 一点都没办法显示出是家的老房子，或者是说跟海狮有点关系的那个，都看不出来，所以就是很希望说政府能把那个老房子，修复了，然后当成一个博物馆或者纪念馆。